When people talk to journalists, they're either often say they're on the record, on background, not for attribution, on deep background, off the record. And while some journalists seem to think there's a set of definitions for each one of those, I found in my practical experience there really isn't. There are different understandings by different people to what those things mean. So explain how you conducted these, because basically the allegation floating out there is people told you things in confidence with the promise or the belief they would never have their name attached to some of these, like the Harry Reid anecdote, and yet their names are attached to them in the book. Can you tell us how that works?
Sure. We did all our interviews for the book on a deep background basis. This is important because we want this to be transparent. We want people to understand that what we did was in order to serve history, to serve the public interest, so these stories could be told. That requires giving people a comfort that their anonymity will be protected. What we did was say you will not be identified as a source in the book. People who are interested in our sourcing and the method we use, we very carefully wrote up that explanation in the author's note of the book. And you'll see in the acknowledgments portion of the author's note, we don't list the names of any of our sources. We were very careful. As we reported on the book, we'd go to person A and we'd do an interview, and then we would go to person B. And if we asked them about information from the first interview into person B, we wouldn't say, person A said this, what do you think about it? We were very careful throughout the process. Part of the reason you referenced before that there wasn't a lot of awareness about not only what was in our book, but even the existence of our book before it came out this week, is because we were very scrupulous and very careful about being quiet about what we were doing, about being quiet about the substance of what we were learning in our interviews. As we've said all along, and it will be true no matter what anyone says, we did not burn any of our sources in writing the book or in talking about the book since it came out. We've been very careful. We take that oath and professional responsibility carefully, and we've fulfilled it.
And Cheryl, I just add that, you know, this is not some novel reporting technique. I mean, you could look at some of the most esteemed figures in our business, people like Bob Woodward, who if you match up some of Bob Woodward's author's notes with our author's note, you'll see they're remarkably similar in terms of the technique that he's employing. You look at a great campaign book like Richard Ben Kramer's What It Takes, it's very similar in trying to achieve the novelistic effect that we've achieved. People have used these same kind of techniques for a long time, and if you look outside the realm of politics, look at Andrew Ross Sorkin's recent book on the Wall Street meltdown. Again, very similar. These are not in any way exotic sourcing techniques that we're using here with the book.